It's Friday, the 4th of November, 2016. Good morning! Chris Reardon with this morning's United Kingdom Talk and the latest craze that the youngsters are getting up to now, boys and girls. In this morning's Superway, Super Soraway Daily Mail, thugs, boys, that could be you. Are you a thug? Do I look like a thug? Come on. I know I've got one of those thug-type haircuts, but I'm not. I'm not a thug. Thugs are body slamming themselves against car windscreens in a new craze, which is sweeping, boys and girls. It is sweeping through Leeds. Don't drive through Leeds. For God's sake, it's dangerous enough up there. Don't drive through Leeds. This woman, Michaela Cam. That's funny when you hear the story. Michaela Cam installed closed circuit television. Did you get it? Cam, closed circuit television. Don't get it. I mean, how thick can you be? Cam, as in camera. Oh dear. Installed closed circuit televisions, just before a week before the incident, due to an increase in antisocial behaviour. Now, we don't like antisocial behaviour on this programme. We're not having any of it. I shall inform you of some more antisocial behaviour before the end of the show, at a place known as Waitrose. Yes, I have received inside information from one of the staff members. Coming up later. Don't rush me. She's recovering from spinal surgery. Now, what that has got to do with this, I don't know. Why is it the papers always try and find something that's wrong with someone when they've had a bad experience? The spinal injury is nothing to do with the body slamming. She wasn't doing the body slamming. Let me continue. She saw footage of a hooded figure. That's just a quick impression of a hooded figure, boys and girls. Oh, look, I look like an egg. Look. One minute. Do I look like an egg? Egg. Smash me over the head with a small teaspoon. Yes. She's recovering from spinal surgery. She saw footage of a hooded figure launching himself at her red Volkswagen Golf. And I can see the Golf, actually. It's a very old Golf, but nevertheless. The 23-second footage shows a teenager charging at the windscreen with his left shoulder and shattering the window before leaping off the bonnet and sprinting away, followed by four friends. Another victim spoke out on social media about her car being body slammed and claimed another 20 or more have been targeted in a similar way across the Leeds area. Meanwhile, images of another incident in Cheshire emerged on social media this morning. When I saw the car, I expected him to have launched a brick at it, but someone said to me, it looks like someone's body slammed into that. When I saw the footage, I was gobsmacked. Oh, that hurt. Hurt my nose. Hit the tip of my nose then. She was gobsmacked. So this is the new craze now. Body slamming. But unfortunately, it involves cars getting damaged at the same time. The story goes on. It makes you wonder if he's prepared and put something on his arm or shoulder to protect himself. That must hurt, surely. It must be like going into a brick wall, mustn't it? A windscreen on a car? I mean, there's been a couple of pigeons in my time as I've been driving along and they don't survive. No, they don't survive. Sometimes if it's an extra large pigeon, you have to put on your windscreen wipers a few times before it shifts them. I actually drove once into a swarm. I think it was wasps or bees. Yeah, just driving along the motorway casually and suddenly all these bees hit my windscreen. I felt ever so guilty. So many funerals had to be conducted. I had a mass said for every single one at a local church that I was attending to at the time, St. Joseph's in Bracknell. Yes. Anyway, so that's the later thing. Please don't do it, boys and girls. Windscreen slamming. You or someone else is going to get damaged at some point. Yes. Now, the Waitrose story. Well. I am shocked and horrified, but pleased at the same time. Speaking secretly to one of the staff yesterday that we happened to bump into as we were out. Apparently, they catch, they have a very nice security man there. Can't think of his name now.
But he used to have dreadlocks. He's cut it all short now. Very, very nice man. Always very pleasant to us. And we met up with this lady about... We bumped into this lady about... about 12 in the afternoon. She'd been at work for 4 hours. And she told me, oh, yes. Yeah, he's already caught 3 people now. I said, do they always prosecute? And she said, yeah, absolutely. Every time they catch someone stealing, they always prosecute. Good. Good. And we know, we actually know when someone's been nicking from Waitrose, because there's a little bit just outside the front of it, like a car park bit, where, you know, if the edge of the pavement goes like that, there it goes like in a bit like that. And just on that side of it is like a gardening section. We'll have the wonderful plants on that through some. Oh, it's deadly, that is. During the summer, myself or my mate can never, ever walk past this bit without purchasing yet another plant for the garden. And fortunately, unlike in Australia, where Simon Hollowhead lives... Good morning, Simon, who has become a regular viewer to this show. He is unfortunately addicted. But we'll come to that later. We'll come to that later. Don't rush me. So where the plant section is, where we always buy plants throughout the summer. Incidentally, Christmas roses are now available. They're a plant. Go and buy some of those and you get flowers in the middle of winter. Very pretty. Very pretty. Anyway, if there is a police car parked in the... I was followed by a police car last night. Oh, yes, on the motor. I think I was going too slow. I told you, I've really slowed down in my new car, my new RAV4 hybrid. It's very, very relaxing. No need to rush anywhere. Just driving along gently. I was followed along in the slow... It's not really called it's slow lane, but you know where I mean. I was on the left-hand side. I was doing about 52 mile an hour. 53 mile an hour, something like that. I reckon they were following me because I was going too slow. They probably thought I was drinking or something like that. Because actually, when people drive, I don't drink at all, but when people drink, they tend to drive more slowly in the hope that that will stop them being pulled over. But in fact, it's more obvious that they're trying to hide something. What was I trying to hide? Nothing. Nothing. But they followed me for a period of time, I suppose. And then eventually they put the foot down and zoomed past me. I suppose eventually they realise you're not wobbling from side to side, so you can't have been drinking. I don't know how it works. I don't know how it was, but I was followed for a while. I thought I was going to be dragged out of the car and thrown to the ground by 2 butch policemen. Sadly, it didn't happen. But never mind. There's more hope next time. Back to the Waitrose story. The Waitrose story. Okay. So that if there's a police car parked in that little bit, we know someone is being... has been caught shoplifting. Yes. And I said to this lady, is it the normal people, you know the sort, walking around in tracksuits? Is it them? She said, well, yeah, you've got those. You've got quite a few of those. She said, but you'd be surprised. A lot of elderly people get caught shoplifting. No, not me. I'm not elderly yet. Middle age. I'm kind of lower middle. In fact, someone last night thought I was 42 years old. Ha ha, yes. See, I don't look my age, do I? Unlike you, Simon. My God, the heat of that Australian sunshine has really damaged your face, isn't it? But never mind, never mind. You can pay and have, like, you know, some of that done, can't you? Some of that, like that Amanda girl. You know, that Amanda girl from Prisoner Cell Block H, who I met on Wednesday. What a lovely girl. She's had a bit done. She looks wonderful. Wonderful, dear. You could have your lips done as well, Simon. That'd be nice. Anyway, yes, so apparently a lot of elderly people nick as well. Disabled people. Oh, yes. Oh, yes. I said, well, how do they nick then? She said, well, what you find is that they've got a blanket over their laps. And they put stuff out there. No, I'm not having a go at disabled people. Don't start with your offence. Oh, I'm disabled. I'm really offended by that. I don't steal anything. I never said you did. But people do. Disabled people, they shove it under their blanket. This comes from the Waitrose lady herself, who is all-seeing and all-knowing. Yes. And she said, surprisingly, we also get regulars who steal. Don't look at me, dear. I have never stolen a thing from Waitrose in my life, I'll have you know. No, I'm a trusted member. I have a green Waitrose card. I haven't got my green Waitrose code here. I just have my Conservative Party membership card here. Thank you very much. Oh, Didn't show you my address then, did I? No, thank you. They'll all turn up here, dear. They all turn up here. Yes. People hoping to catch a glimpse of me in normal everyday activities and not in my studio like I am now. Is that bad English? They do. I see them outside sometimes. They hide behind trees and bushes with cameras. Oh, quick, there's Chris Reardon. It's a little bit like that, really. And sometimes I notice things have gone missing and they turn up on eBay. Spider plant from Chris Reardon's house. Starting bid £250. You know, spider plants would not normally be worth that amount. But the very fact that I have tended it to that with my own fair hands, you see, that's what it is. That's what makes them worth the money. So, yes, all sorts of people steal from Waitrose, but they prosecute them every time. Good, good, good. Absolutely good. That man's very good, that man. I wonder what makes him not follow me around. Do I have a honest Chris face? Because I don't think I've ever been followed around in there, actually. No, never. Unless maybe they secretly watch me from their cameras. That always worries me, really. You know, people watching me through a camera. Not sort of this show, you know, but, you know, strange people watching people through cameras. You don't know who's watching these security cameras, do you? Eh? It does make me laugh. You know, you go to your nephew's school, or, well, in my case, my great-nephew's or great-niece's school now, because we've gone above having nephews now. We've got great-nephews now and great-nieces. You know, if I was to go to my great-niece or great-nephew's, nursery school, well, can I take a photo of... No, don't take any pictures of my kids. You're taking pictures of my kids. Why are you taking pictures of my kids? And they all start screaming and shouting at you. And then they come out of that very same school and walk past all these cameras in the street. Well, at least you know it's me taking the photo. Who do you know who's sitting up there in their little office with the joystick? Oh, that one looks quite nice. Oh, yes, yes, let's have a look at that one. Zoom in. Yes, pervs. Pervs are watching these security cameras now, dear. Look, they're peering at you. Peering. So that's the Waitrose story, you see. All sorts of people. It don't always blame those people in tracksuits. All sorts of elderly people, disabled people, people from everywhere. Watch out. And if you see someone thieving from Waitrose, report them. You could go to Linda or Jackie or Michelle on the customer services desk in Bracknell. There, we'd love to have a conversation in there, dear. Oh, we love it here. Anyway, back to the stories. Let's do some messages from yesterday's show. There he is, little Simon Hollerhead. How are you, Simon Hollerhead in Australia? Who says, I didn't think life could get any worse. What do you mean by that? Anyway, I'm now hooked on watching your bloody webcast. Now, we don't usually allow swearing on this programme, Simon. We really don't. Just because you're in Australia, you shouldn't let your things down. What's it? Not trousers, no. White pant parts. No, that's not. standards. Just because you're in Australia, Simon, don't let your standards down. Remember, you are British. Land of hope. And we don't swear here in the United Kingdom. We are all very nice. And a very good morning. Everyone says good morning. When you're going through London here, you know, as you know, Simon, people, you can't get from one street to the other. Good morning, good morning. And we all tip our hats and all that business. Very, very friendly over here. Very friendly, Simon. No need to use such language on my email. I may have to delete that comment from my Facebook wall. People will be horrified. People like Shania, good church-going Shania. Good morning, Shania on the Isle of Wight, who now has passed some sort of test and has an apprenticeship. Yeah. Well done, Shania. I'm not sure what in. What are you apprenticeshipping in? Is it a shop or a business or what? Do tell us, Shania. We need detailed email on exactly what you're doing, my darling, okay? Yes, Simon says, I'm now hooked on watching your webcasts. Well, I don't like to call them a webcast. I kind of, it's a television show, dear. This is, I am a television personality. I really am, darling. I have no explanation for this. It says more about my life than your broadcasts, I feel. Might be changed. Time to change your medication. Oh, are you on those pills as well, Simon? Isn't that funny? And yet we had such a laugh in the 90s? In the early 90s, talking about such things. Me too. Me too. What can you do, darling? What can you do? Simon also says, I'm up to the last third of your show now. This is yesterday's show that he was peering at. And the thing about university, the jealousy is overwhelming. It really put me off. Yes, I went to Oxford. Boring? Well, There are published photographs to disapprove that. So disappointing, Christopher. I have no interest in university, Simon. You know that, dear. It would be so boring. I was out there earning money, dear. This is why I'm so rich now and own half of London, renting it out. I am a slum landlord. I am, Simon. You know that. I have little one-bedroom flats and 500 people are renting a room from me in that one single room. Bunk beds all in there, stacked one. They actually have to slide it. They sleep like this. I'm a... Good morning to Alan Russell. Morning, Alan. Who says, first thing I do when I wake up is watch your broadcast. You don't... Really, Alan? What, when you're still in bed? So are you saying that I'm actually in bed with you first thing in the morning? Well, I hope you get up and brush your teeth. Oh, there's nothing worse than that, is it, boys and girls? When you turn over and some... Oh, God. Get up and brush your teeth, please, immediately. Disgusting. Good morning to Ray Reynolds. Ray Reynolds says, hi, Chris. When you said Bobby Davro, you meant Bradley Walsh. It's an easy thing to get them confused. They all used to be on the Des O'Connor Show from Thames Television, Teddington Lock, Middlesex. And I mean that most sincerely. Incorrect, Ray Reynolds. Ray Reynolds, you've made an error. I did, in fact, mean Bobby Davro. I have also met Bobby Davro at the King's Head Theatre Bar. They all come in there, dear. That was a few months ago now. And he commented, actually, it's probably about a year ago, that one. He commented on my very nice, I had my blue Ralph Lauren jacket, not this one, my blue Ralph Lauren jacket on that day. And he said how much he liked it. Yes. And that he enjoyed my quiz. Yes. Bobby Davro. I've met them all, dear. Bobby Davro, Bradley Walsh, Amanda McGuddon. They're all there. Oh, the girl from Doctor Who, Jo. What was her name? Jo. She was John Pertwee's assistant. You know, the one with the little blonde hair. Pretty thing. Various others. Casualty extras I've met in there. Someone who played Charlie Fairhead's son. They all go in there, dear. All of them. Good morning to Simon Keane, who says, in 2034, next time Supermoon, I will be 64. Will you still feed me? Will you still need me when I'm 64? Feed me on a Milky Way or a Mars? I suppose we'll be... I do hope I will be alive to see us start space travelling as a normal thing. I think it'd be quicker than getting through London, to be honest. God's sake. Oh, it just gets worse and worse. I just know tonight... I'm in King's Cross tonight, and I know that's going to be another hour and 45 minutes there. But never mind, sitting in the new car, and there's nothing wrong with my new car because it was obviously closely inspected by the police yesterday as they were following me, going too slow probably. Simon also says, my ex, because we were singing yesterday, born with a smile on my face. My ex was born with a smile on her face. Unfortunately, it was upside down. Oh, was she miserable? Oh, we don't like miserable exes, do we? No, goodbye. Bye-bye. Go and be miserable yourself, please. We don't want to know. Thank you very much. Yes. Good. So they're the messages from yesterday's show, boys and girls. Let me see. Oh, have you seen the new Sky News? I don't know if I've mentioned this or not yet, but I flicked it on this morning because Victoria Derbyshire was on BBC One Colour. And BBC News 24, or the BBC News channel, she's on there. Now, she's very good, but you don't get the news properly. So at 9 o'clock in the morning, I tend to have Sky News on. That's not actually the Sky News jingle. That's the Sky Movies jingle from the 80s. Yes, I remember that one. Oh, it was a lovely tune. Would you like to hear it? Shall I see if I can play it? It's an excellent, excellent piece of music. One moment, please. We're now trying to connect you. Sky Movies... Sky Movies Ident. Let's try that. Sky Movies Ident. Oh, this is the... No, this is the one. 1992, I think it is. One moment, please. Let me just bring that up on my system for your entertainment. Thank you very much. Oh, this is the one. Sky Movies. Here it comes. Here it comes.
Sky Movies Plus, a part of the British Sky Broadcasting Network. Now on Midsummer.
Oh, I love it. I love all these old jingles. Isn't it fabulous, YouTube? You can virtually put in anything old on YouTube and it will be there. Even my name. Even my name. Lovely. Let's do today's birthdays, boys and girls. Good morning today to Lily. Oh, it's Lily. Lilibeth Gevero is her whole name, but we know her as Lily. Top karaoke singer and all-round nice person. It is her birthday today. 48 years old today. Happy birthday, Lily. Come and sing soon, my darling. Oh, she's such a lovely little creature. She sits near the front of the stage and patiently waits her turn, and she's very friendly with everyone else. Happy birthday, Lily. Happy birthday today to William Coughlin. Now, when have I last saw you, dear? It's over 10 years ago now. Kitty Litter extraordinaire, wonderful drag queen who upsets all the other ones. We love it, dear. Give them a piece of their own medicine. Happy birthday, William. Lovely to see you soon, sir. Happy birthday today to Alison, Phillips. And happy birthday today to Mark Pulley. There's a little face. Hello, Mark. That's a lovely... What is that event on your Facebook wall there? It's like everyone's sitting down. Is it a meal? You look like you're having a dinner. And there's all like things hanging down from the ceiling and pretty little sparkly lights there. Oh, there were sparkly lights in Waitrose yesterday. Yes, they've got like a Christmas section has appeared now. And there's little flashing white light, little LEDs everywhere. Flashing, it's very, very Christmassy. We wish you a Merry Christmas, but not yet because it's too early. There won't be any Christmas decorations in here until a week before. Absolutely not. I do not believe in putting up Christmas decorations until... about a week before Christmas, so you won't be seeing anything like that. And it's already, oh yes, I've got little Christmas idents wishing you Merry Christmas for the beginning and the end of the show. It's all very, we're planned weeks in advance here. Months and months in advance. We are. Here comes the song. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, Lily, William, Alison and Mark. Happy birthday to you. All right? Have a wonderful birthday, boys and girls, OK? I hope you have a really nice day. Tonight, it's Friday night, so I'll be hosting karaoke at Central Station Bar in Wharfdale Road, King's Cross in London. Starts at 8:30. And finishes at 12 midnight, OK? Be lovely to see you, some of you down there singing along with the karaoke. We don't do serious karaoke. If you want to sing serious, that's fine. But it's all about having a little bit of a laugh, boys and girls, and all about being friendly with everyone else and having a go. You don't have to be a brilliant singer. We don't care if you can't sing. It's about coming on the stage and having a go. All right, so I might see you there. Once again, tonight, karaoke every single Friday at Central Station, Wharfdale Road, King's Cross, starts at 8:30 and finishes at midnight. Apart from that, have a very cold Friday. It's cold today. And don't forget your sparklers for tomorrow night. See you soon. Cheerio.